Well, I guess you do quite a lot of entertaining at home for business reasons.
No, I don't.
Well, that's too bad, because that bottle of wine, for instance, is deductible.
Deductible?
Mm-hmm, of course deductible. Anything you spend for tax advice is an entirely legal tax deduction.
Oh.
Oh, how many rooms have you got here?
Well, this is it.
Oh. Where do you sleep?
Oh, that's very tricky. You just press a button, the bed sort of pops out of the wall.
What?
I'll show you. It sort of goes whoosh. Watch out.
Oh, that's wonderful. That's amazing. Gee, but that's American ingenuity. Looks very comfortable.
Yes, it is.
That's wonderful. It must work on a spring principle, I imagine.
Yes. Press a button, it comes out. Press another button, it goes right back. Watch out now. You don't want to get wounded in that other hand.
You know, I can't get over that. It's...
Well, I'm afraid you'll just have to. Are you ready for my canceled checks now?
Yes, I guess we better get down to business.
I think I have most of them. I'm afraid a few might be missing.
Missing?
I sent them to the laundry.
Hmm?
Or I had them in one of my pockets. I picked them up in the mailbox on the way to the studio. Well, that was on a Tuesday. I mean, that's the day the laundry gets sent.
What?
It could happen to anyone.
Well, we won't worry about it. We'll just do the best we can.
Oh.
Now, the idea is first to separate the checks into two stacks. You see, deductible and non-deductible.
I see.
Now, for instance, who or what is Otis J. Lemmon?
Who?
Who or what is Otis J. Lemmon? On March 4th, he wrote a check for $14.37 to one Otis J. Lemmon. Do you have any idea what that might be for?
No.
It's interesting, really. It's very interesting.
What?
Well, it's wonderful, really. I always say you can never really get to know a person well until you've been through her canceled checks.
You can't?
Beat psychiatry, palm reading, and, you know, feeling the bumps on someone's head.
Phrenology?
Well, anyway, I can tell everything about a person from their canceled checks.
Can you tell about me?
Everything.
Everything?
Everything.
Well, is it all right?
Well, yes. You're frivolous, romantic, generous, somewhat over-impulsive. You're ambitious. You're a little scatterbrained. You also have a weakness for lacy underwear.
Well, that's uncanny.
You're also very pretty. Very sweet. And you like to be kissed.
Oh, the checks. Oh, I'm sorry.
Well, that's all right. You can send those to the laundry, too.
Maybe before this goes any further, I ought to look at your canceled checks.
You'll find I'm honest, thrifty, methodical, sober, upright, and really kind of dull.
I don't believe it.
Don't say it anymore.
I won't.
Nina?
Yes?
I've been thinking.
Yes?
About your income tax situation.
Do we have to discuss that tonight?
Well, now, wait. Now, this is very important. You have a basic salaried income of $3,380 per annum. Is that correct?
That's right, if that's what $65 a week comes to. Yes, I don't see why we have to discuss it.
Well, now, I shall shortly be earning $5,200 myself. And to get to the point, if we were to file a joint return, it would seem to me that with the two exemptions, a joint return would not only be feasible, but actually economically very sound. Indeed. Tax-wise.
All right. I didn't think you could do that. File a joint return just like that. I thought you had to be married or something. Oh. Oh.
It was just like a movie, you know? They were married and they lived happily ever after.